The Technogym Skill Run Unity 7000 treadmill has 20 controls, over 50 tiles, and too many submenus and settings to count. Part 1 covered the console's screen and physical controls, and in this Part 2 video, I'll give you a walkthrough of all the screen tiles, their submenus, and settings. Part 3 will cover the hidden system settings. To begin, touch the screen to turn off the screensaver or to wake up a blank screen. Here are all the tiles on the main home screen if you're not exercising and not logged in, and it doesn't let users rearrange the tiles. I categorize the screen tiles into 6 groups, which I'll present in this order: settings, entertainment, login, workouts, exercise feedback, and exercise controls. The 3 settings tiles are the Samsung Watch connection, the Apple Watch connection, and the language tile. If you're not logged in, the language tile lets you choose which language you want displayed on screen. If you are logged in, it uses the language listed in your My Wellness profile and the language tile won't show up. There are 25 entertainment tiles, which I categorize into 6 groups: information and services, video, radio and streaming, news, social media, and games. Some of these entertainment activities require paid accounts, some provide free accounts, and some don't require accounts. The information and services tiles are a web browser, TripAdvisor, Google Maps, and Gmail. The video tiles are YouTube, Netflix, Plex, BBC iPlayer, TED, Ventura TV, and Vivo. The radio and streaming, music and news tiles are TuneIn Radio, Pandora, Deezer, BBC iPlayer Radio, and Fit Radio. The news tiles are Bloomberg, CNN, BBC News, Flipboard, and Eurosport.com. The social media tiles are Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, and Twitter. The games tile is the only group tile, and it contains 5 game tiles: Angry Birds, Mahjong, Klondike, which is a solitaire card game, Sudoku, and Backgammon. The login tile lets you log into MyWellness.com, which is owned and managed by Technogym. And if you exercise while you're logged in, it will record most of your exercise results for you. Here's a past exercise report with color charts for pace, gradient, cadence, heart rate zones, and a table with duration, distance, calories, average pace, average speed, and average and maximum heart rates. You can log in with an email address and password, or by using the on-screen QR code with your smartphone, or by using a smartphone with near-field communication, or your gym might give you a TSG key for logins. If you log in, then the Skill Run will automatically offer to start a training program you have stored in My Wellness, but you can just touch the home button to choose a different way to exercise. You can get back to your stored training programs with the Training Exercise tile, which only appears when you're logged in. If the Skill Run you're using is in your home and in family mode instead of facility mode, your screen won't have the yellow login tile, and instead you just touch your profile to log in to your free account at MyWellness.com. Finally, we've gotten to the reason the Skill Run exists. A workout consists of one or more exercises, and the Skill Run's 9 workout tiles are performance training, routine, speed shift, marathon, outdoors, training, boot camp, exercises, and start. With many workouts and exercises on the Skill Run, you'll need to choose one or more settings, such as how long to exercise or how difficult you want the exercise to be. There are 2 main ways to choose. Touch a presented choice, such as parachute size, or use a slider bar. You can drag slider bars left or right, or you can touch the minus or plus buttons. The performance training tile takes you to three options: sled, parachute, and run against resistance. In sled mode, you push against the treadmill's frame with straight arms or bent arms, and the resistance starts out hard and gets easier as you gain momentum, just like a real training sled. To use this exercise, you need to choose the starting weight of the virtual sled, the number of repetitions you want to perform, and the distance you want to push the sled during each rep. If you want to, you can also change the default number of seconds for how long you'll rest between reps. In parachute mode, you pull against the parachute belt, and the resistance gets harder the faster you run, just like running with a real athletic parachute. The run against resistance mode is sled style pushing, but the resistance remains steady the entire time. The routine tile takes you to three options: cardio fit, strong legs, and speed and agility drills. These all create predefined exercise sessions for you after you choose how long it will run and the difficulty level, although you can change the difficulty level at any time while you're exercising. Cardio Fit has speed changes while walking or running, flat or uphill, from very easy to very hard. The strong legs and the speed and agility drills both have the same one-sentence description here, with sled, lunges, and uphill runs. They both include walking, running, and pushing, and the difference between them is that strong legs includes lunges and crossovers, and the speed and agility drills include side shuffles, butt kicks, high knees, and karaoke. Both of them let you choose how long you want to exercise and what your effort level will be. The screens for these routine programs always show you a chart of your progress in the exercise session, a video of how to do the current drill, which drill is next, and a countdown timer for when your next drill will start. The speed shift tile lets you create an exercise that switches between 2, 3, or 4 speeds, and you choose when to shift speeds by using the physical speed shifter handle. The marathon tile lets you choose animated scenery for a marathon, 15K, 10K, or 5K race in New York City or Rome, Italy. For each location, you have 4 distances to choose from: the starting line for the full 26.2 miles, or begin 15K, 10K, or 5K from the finish line. You can control the incline or let the program match the incline to the real race course. The animation doesn't show other runners, just the scenery, and the faster you walk or run, the faster the scenery goes by. The outdoors tile lets you choose between 8 different point of view videos, and you can let the program match the incline to the video, or you can control the incline. Each scene has 4 stages, and you can start at any stage, and you can switch between videos or stages without stopping. How long each stage takes depends on how fast you walk or run, and the faster you walk or run, the faster the scenery goes by. If you start your exercise with the outdoors tile and then switch away from it while you're still exercising, that will stop the exercise. But you can also start an outdoors video after manually starting the tread, in which case you can switch away from the video and come back to it with the video still running. This method uses the outdoors video as entertainment and lets you switch between the outdoors videos, the exercise home screen, the biofeedback screen, the SwiftPad screen, the table screen, or any of the entertainment options. The training tile only appears if you're logged in. This tile allows you to start exercising based on exercise programs you have stored in MyWellness.com, and these programs can include non-treadmill activities. The boot camp tile is a high-intensity interval training workout that lets you switch quickly and repeatedly between running mode, sled mode, and parachute mode. You control when or if you switch modes, so you can use this to do HIIT in one, two, or all three modes. There's one major feature in the boot camp's running mode which you can't get from the other exercise tiles. The speed buttons on the SwiftPad and boot camp provide much faster than usual acceleration and deceleration. The gradient pad, which controls the incline or slope, will change at the same speed it always does, but the speed is a very different story. If you change speeds any other way on the skill run, it accelerates gently, like any other treadmill. But thanks to the skill run's 10 horsepower main motor, if you change the speed using the Swift Pad and boot camp, be ready, because it's going to speed up fast. I'll show you how amazing this is in a dedicated video on using boot camp for elite HIIT training. The exercises tile is blue if you're not logged in, and yellow if you are logged in. It has 10 submenus and over 40 second level submenus with customizable exercises, predefined exercises, adaptive exercises, and submaximal, maximal, and military performance tests. If you've ever done a free workout while logged in, the submenus of the exercises tile includes the last performed submenu. A free workout is one where you manually control changes in speed and incline. And last performed lets you repeat a previous free workout, although you can change the speeds and inclines during a replayed workout if you want to. You can open a last performed workout and tag it as a favorite. And if you've tagged one or more favorites, a favorites submenu will also be added to the exercises submenus. You can reuse your favorite workouts as many times as you wish if you're logged in. The Routines submenu has the same set of three routines you get from the routine tile on the main homepage: cardio fit, strong legs, and speed and agility drills. There are 8 submenus under On Trend, and the first three are sled, run against resistance, and parachute, which are the same ones on the performance training tile. The cadence training exercise is unique as it's the only option that will drill you based on your steps per minute. The fifth exercise here is speed shift, and it's the same as using the speed shift tile on the main homepage. Sixth is high-low blocks, which changes speeds in big steps. Once you start a high-low workout, the skill run opens the default exercise home screen, but I prefer to switch to the table tile so I can see the changes that are coming. Next is hills, which sounds like it might vary the incline, but it doesn't. It varies the speed, and it varies the speed slowly compared to high-low blocks. Like the high-low blocks, after you start a hills workout, you have to manually switch to the table tile to see the changes that are coming. Lastly, the cross-training exercise combines a variety of high-low and hill speed changes, and it also requires you to manually switch to the table view. And yes, if you noticed the duration options are different between high-low blocks, hills, and cross-training, those variations are really the way they are on my skill run. The three goal-driven workouts let you set a time, distance, or calorie goal, then you start a free workout, except that the skill run will count down towards your goal and stop when you reach it. With the three heart rate driven workouts, which all require a heart rate monitor wirelessly connected to the skill run, the treadmill will vary the speed to try to keep your pulse constant, or within a training zone, or within a range to maximize weight loss. The advanced custom workout lets you define as many steps as you wish, and in the time mode, define the speed, incline, and duration for each step. For the distance mode, define the speed, incline, and total distance for each step. For the advanced preset profiles, choose one of the six profiles which vary the speeds and inclines in accordance with the illustrations provided. The 22 submaximal, maximal, and military performance tests programmed into the skill run are designed to help you determine your general fitness level, specific fitness levels, or estimate your lung capacity as maximum oxygen volume, which is called VO2 max. In other words, these are intended to measure your current fitness, not to improve your fitness. The best use of these performance tests for most people may be to use one of them periodically to see if your fitness is improving. For that, you should use the same test each time so it's an accurate comparison. You can do these tests on your own, and the skill run can give you your test results and sometimes recommend a starting effort level for skill run exercises. But the skill run doesn't explain the tests, and the maximal and military tests can be dangerous if you aren't healthy enough for them. Any exercise can be dangerous to people who are unfit, have physical limitations, or have certain health problems. But if you're going to do a treadmill performance test, submaximal tests are safest because they don't push you to the maximum limits of your heart or lungs. Maximal performance tests are considered the gold standard for accurately assessing maximal aerobic capacity, but only for people who are fit enough to perform them safely. The green start tile will immediately start the treadmill with a slow walking speed and no incline. This is called a free workout because the skill run doesn't automate any changes for you and you have all the entertainment options available. After a free workout starts, you can change the speed and incline anytime you want. There are countless ways to exercise on a skill run, but you can always just get on, touch the start tile, and start walking or running. That's the last of the 9 workout tiles, and brings us to the exercise feedback tiles, which only appear when the tread is running. The standard performance tiles appear on this exercise home screen and provide information about your current performance, the time elapsed since your exercise session started, the estimated calories burned, the distance you've walked or run, your heart rate, the number of moves, your pace, the gradient, also known as the incline or slope, and your speed. I had never heard of moves and couldn't find any useful information about it online, so I asked TechnoGym what it was. They got back to me and said it's not an acronym, it's just a TechnoGym alternative to calories and metabolic equivalent of tasks, better known as METs. While you're exercising, several of these performance metrics may be displayed in a status bar at the bottom of your screen. The biofeedback tile provides graphical advanced performance metrics, but only if you're running at least 5 miles per hour. These are running power in watts, cadence in steps per minute, propulsion time in milliseconds, step length for each leg in inches or centimeters, ground contact time for each leg in milliseconds, and flight time in milliseconds. Propulsion time is how long your feet are pushing on the tread, from mid-stride to toe-off, and is part of ground contact time. Flight time is when neither foot is touching the tread. Basic performance metrics are displayed in the standard status bar below the biofeedback metrics, and you can touch the status bar to expand it and show additional metrics, or to adjust the speed or incline. This advanced biofeedback feature is only available on the SkillRun Unity 7000, and it uses a special sensor in the console to watch your feet. I'm not sure exactly how it works, but I suspect it's just making estimates, not precise measurements. And after using it a bunch, I think it doesn't adjust very quickly when you change your stride. The apparent latency seems to make this feature unsuitable for sprints of less than about 10 seconds long. The table tile gives you a time chart of your speed, incline, and heart rate, although it won't show the incline if you've had it at 0% since you started the workout, and it won't show the heart rate if you don't have a heart rate monitor connected. This is perfect when you want to see a history of your speed and incline changes while you're doing impromptu exercise, just changing them when you feel like it, or if you want to see a chart of your heart rate since you started the workout. Also, in some pre-programmed exercises, such as the cardio routine, the same table is shown in the top left area of the screen. The exercise control tiles only appear when the tread is running. The SwiftPad tile lets you make single-touch impromptu changes to incline, speed, or pace. You have to touch the Speed-Pace button to switch between the speed and pace grids. The SwiftPad looks almost the same as the one in Bootcamp's running mode, but this one changes speeds normally, while the Bootcamp version changes speeds much faster. If you only want to change speeds between 2, 3, or 4 specific speeds during your exercise, you can use the Speed Shift program instead of the SwiftPad. The Pause Stop tile, sometimes labeled Stop Pause, will pause the treadmill when you touch it, start a countdown timer, and give you a stop tile and a restart tile. If you don't do anything before it times out, it will end the workout. If you touch restart, it picks up where it left off, and if you touch stop, it will end your workout. Stopping a workout will cause a results screen to pop up. The results screen is titled Cool Down, but stopping the workout with pause then stop is different from stopping it with the Cool Down tile, because pause then stop actually stops the tread. The Cool Down tile will end your workout, but it won't stop the tread. Cool down will keep the tread going for several minutes at half the speed and half the incline it was at before, while it shows you the summary of your workout. During a cool down or during performance tests, there will only be a stop tile instead of a pause stop. Note that the physical stop button on the handlebar doesn't work like the pause stop tile because it won't pause a workout and will just immediately end your workout and very quickly stop the tread. You can let the skill run log you out automatically after a short period of inactivity or after a workout ends, or you can touch the My Wellness tile and then touch the logout button. You can see some of your workout history here, but if you go to your account at mywellness.com, You get a lot more information there. This video was the hardest I've made so far, and I hope you like it. With this video and its Part 1 companion, I've tried to show you everything you'd like to know about what the skill run can do and how to make it do it, so you can get the most out of it if you have one at your gym or at your home, or to make a fully informed decision if you're thinking about buying one. You probably won't need to know about the hidden system settings, but I'm going to show those anyway in a short Part 3 video to complete this set of videos. I'd like to give special thanks to my daughter Rebecca for helping me with the numerous and exhausting tests of combinations of cameras, resolutions, frame rates, and lighting configurations before finally finding one that was of at least adequate quality for recording the Skill Run's screen. Thanks for watching, and keep walking, running, or sprinting.